So, it's now dry, and you can see that working backwards doesn't particularly work that well, I don't think. It depends the effects you want, but there's some nice textural effect here and in various places. So, I'm now just going to re-wet some of this and just wait for that to do its thing. Pops a bit of a warmer mixture in the foreground here. It's just back into that green mixture again. Don't need to be too precise with that. We'll pop in some of this, just a dab here and there, and just let it do its own thing. Now then, back into these reeds and mixtures here. We'll just keep this really simple. Pop those in. Pop in some grey reeds. That's just going up the top there. This is it's a quick way. Normally I mix greys up. This is just a quick way of doing it with the neutral chint, as long as we keep it nice and wet. There we go, that'll do there to keep some light sparkling in through. This is kind of painting itself again, which is always good. Let's just run that off there, and you see now where I've taped everything up, because I'm quite a messy painter when it comes to watercolour. We'll pop some of these other little mixtures in and around this tree here. This kind of comes out here as well a bit. Obviously this is all going to be pulled off as tape. It's just getting the flavour of this painting. This could be a bit darker in terms of tone. Pop in some liquid in here, and of course we need to make sure we've got some water in there as well, so we can just blend and bleed a bit. And then we have that here as well, reflected into the water's edge. So we can just dot in some colour to blend in there. And across here, just suggest a bank coming around here, and then kind of take it out. This doesn't need to be too defined, it's just secondary to the rest of the painting, these reeds that are here. And indeed any reeds that are popping up along here as well. They're all kind of secondary. Just going to finally go back into some of this. Make sure that's... I just want to go in a bit darker in places, not everywhere, but just to sharpen some edges up as they've kind of lost their way a bit. It's always good to have lost and found edges, so edges that come back and in strength and just fade out again. But we certainly need to have restraint just down this side, and the original was quite dark. Just let it do its own thing down in there. And just a few more pops of darker, sharper mixture just here and there. Not too much. And that will probably do it. Oh, we've got drops coming out. One annoying thing you can get with these travel brushes, there's the handle that comes off on this one. There. They've got a hole in the bottom where water will leak out. And that I find quite annoying sometimes if it gets filled up with clear water. You can see it's just, we had a drop down there. Just here, I think it was. We'll just take that off. Let's take out some of that, it's quite strong. I don't want any of this really to dominate at all. It's just secondary to the tree, as we said earlier. So it's a mixture of blurred edges and sharp edges that kind of make it, really. Hopefully you've enjoyed that. And I'm going to stop there and dry it off, and we'll be done. Finished. Fiddle around all day long, can't we? Get the idea. There you go. Winter Tree, Castle Acre. Hopefully you can see all the moves that I popped in there. Thanks a lot. Remember to subscribe and comment, and we'll see you again soon. So the final thing to do, as ever, is the unveiling. I've just taken off this piece of tape on the left-hand side. I'll take off this piece of tape on the right. Excuse me. This piece here. And then along the bottom. Just straighten that up. And there. A nice little sketch. Always the last little thing to do. Let's get the name on the sketch. Sign with the pen. Done. Thanks a lot. See you again soon.